What happens to your body during exercise? Number 12. Muscles. According to livestrong.com, your muscles form some of the integral tissues in your body, and tissue changes occur with resistance exercise. Any form of exercise which includes lifting weights, jogging, or doing pushups is some kind of resistance activity being placed on your muscles. When the resistance is greater than what your body can handle, muscle building or muscle hypertrophy is activated. So more blood is driven to the muscles being exercised to give additional oxygen. Without the supplemental oxygen, lactic acid will form in the body instead, but it is usually flushed out of the body within half an hour to an hour after working out. Tiny tears build in the muscle, which helps them become active and bigger as they heal. This is perfectly normal.
The greater the tear, the more sore you'll be after exercising.
This typically only lasts a few days, as soreness means there are changes in your muscles. Number 11. Heart. As with any workout, your heart rate increases because you're working much harder than you normally are. How much your rate will go up depends on how fit you are and the type of exercise you're doing. Training experts vary on how high your heart rate should be when working out, but it does need to be significantly higher than your resting heart rate to enhance your cardiovascular fitness. As you begin your workout, your skeletal muscles compress the veins near them, which push the blood towards your heart. They contract and relax, driving extra blood to your heart, which causes your heart rate to go up. Within this process, it means you're putting more labor on your arm and leg muscles, which pump more blood to your heart. So when working out, your heart will get used to high-level performance, and these changes will minimize your resting heart rate and boost your heart rate recovery after you exercise. Number 10. Lungs.
During your workout, aside from your heart, another vital organ comes into action, the lungs.
Your lungs provide energy, oxygen, and eliminate carbon dioxide, which is created when producing energy. When you have healthy lungs, you keep maintaining a large breathing reserve. You may feel out of breath after intense activity, but you will not be out of breath. When your muscles and your body start to work harder, you will use more oxygen and make more carbon dioxide. To bear with the extra demand, you will start to increase your breathing from about 10 to 15 times a minute. Your circulation will also increase to force oxygen to your muscles so they can keep moving. When your lung function is cut short, you use a larger part of your breathing reserve, which can feel uncomfortable as you try to catch your breath. This is entirely normal, and this type of training helps with circulation. Regular exercise activity can improve the function and strength of your lungs, making it more efficient. Number 9. Skin. When you exercise, you're increasing blood flow, which helps maintain skin cells and keep them nourished. Your blood transports nutrients and oxygen to the cells working throughout your entire body, including the skin. In addition, it improves wrinkles and acne and can even reverse skin aging. Also, blood flow aids in washing away any waste products, which flushes cellular debris from your body. Think of it as cleansing your body, but from the inside. Sweating can help drive out the toxins in your body, but don't assume this is a quick fix to vanish pimples. Exercise, then shower afterward. Working out also helps to flush out your pores. With aerobic exercise, oxygenated blood circulates throughout your entire body, which will cause you to glow because your blood vessels fill up closer to the surface. After an intense workout, your vessels dilate, which gives your skin a vibrant and healthy look. Not only doing exercise will boost your collagen, but it'll help keep your skin firm, elastic, and supple. Number 8. Hair. Sweating through exercise flushed out toxins and waste from our body, and when we sweat from our scalp, it aids to unclog the hair follicles. This allows enough space for new hair to grow.
This gives nourishment to hair roots, which also promotes healthy hair growth.
In fact, exercising and its effects have been compared to the result of an oil massage, since both increase blood circulation and can relax you. Moderate to high-level cardio activity like cycling, dance, running, yoga, and Zumba is beneficial for healthy hair, while inversion yoga poses like shoulder stands, downward-facing dog, sun salutation, and headstands are excellent for healthy hair growth. These inversion positions increase blood flow to your scalp and fix hormonal imbalances, which contribute to hair loss. Number 7. Liver. Located right below your diaphragm, centered in the upper right side of your abdomen, is your liver, which lies under your ribs. When you're overweight, this puts a burden on your liver. So by exercising, your total body fat is cut down, and the fat content in your liver is also reduced as well, which decreases reduction of elevated liver enzymes. When you exercise, the workouts you do shapes the liver by boosting its capability to drain and fill at its maximum capacity. Through maximizing its circulatory ability, your liver is able to withstand liver tissue tissue degeneration. A few simple moves to enhance your liver's health is trunk turning. Start off by sitting upright with your legs crossed with overlying palms over your lower stomach. Turn to your left and right side about 15 times, then turn from side to side in a gentle motion. Then in a center pose, join your hands and fingers and interlock, then push your palms forward about 8 times. Number 6. Joints. Physical activity puts additional weight on the joints, sometimes even up to 5 or 6 times more than your average body weight. Your ankles, elbows, hips and knees, and shoulders all have different roles but work in similar ways. Each joint in your body is surrounded with cushioning tissue called cartilage at the ends of your bones. The lubricating fluid and soft tissue help to provide easy and smooth motion movements while your ligaments and tendons supply stability.
The cushioning around your joints can begin to degenerate or wear down over time.
This is common in people with osteoarthritis, so by exercising, the tissue becomes healthy and serves as a brace to protect your joints and lessen the pressure. Nutrients circulate to the joint since physical activity pushes water molecules out of the cartilage, just like a sponge. In addition, cellular waste is eliminated, where damaged cells are broken down and destroyed. Number 5. Brain. As we age, the formation of new brain cells slow down, and our brain tissue also shrinks. So by exercising, it helps improve brain growth by driving blood flow to the brain. It also promotes memory strength and heightens the body's production of dopamine and serotonin, which are feel-good chemicals. Exercise can help lift up your mood and can help ease depression and anxiety. Working out also improves the brain's executive functions, which allow us to organize better and focus more on complex tasks. Since brain cells are depleted during times of high stress, physical activity lowers cortisol levels. It is also thought that exercise helps promote new nerve cells in the hippocampus, which is connected to producing new memories. This helps eliminate scattered, slow thinking, and forgetfulness. When you work out regularly, exercise triggers the release of neurotransmitters, which cause you to have runner's high due to endorphins. The pituitary gland alerts the adrenal gland in the brain to pump out these hormones needed for movement. Number 4. Back. For most back problems caused by poor posture or minimal movement, exercise and physical activity are natural solutions. Progressive, gradual, and controlled exercise rather than bed rest is actually the best long-term fix for reducing back pain. When you exercise, you are repairing and nourishing spinal structures, which can help aid existing back problems. Exercise and movement keep your back flexible and strong and reduces the risk of injuries and back pain. When you participate in fitness activities, you're keeping your back healthy by allowing the disc to interchange fluids.
This is how the disc gets its nutrition.
A good disc will fill with water and squeeze it out, and fluid trade reduces the swelling in other tissues that naturally happens surrounding injured discs. When there is no exercise involved, the enlargement increases and the disc gets degenerated and malnourished, so working out stretches, repairs, and strengthens the muscles supporting your back. Number 3. Immune system. Working out keeps the lymph system in good condition. Your body typically has 500 lymph nodes, which are tissues that get rid of metabolic waste. But this waste can't be removed without the help of nearby muscles. So when your muscles contract during exercise, it puts pressure on lymph nodes that pump out the waste from your body. Working out also produces white cells in the body, and with more white cells means fewer bacteria and viruses. In fact, PhD director David Neiman of the Human Performance Labs of Appalachian State University states that just 45 minutes of walking every day can reduce the number of work days you miss due to sickness up to 50%. Exercise is a natural stimulus that is proven to boost your immune system's capability to identify and destroy toxins and harmful invaders. Number 2. Waistline. Worried about your love handles? Don't worry, exercise can make them disappear. But did you know it's the loss of excess fat buried inside your body that helps your overall looks and vitality? Your body contains two different types of fat: subcutaneous fat, which is the one you can pinch, and visceral fat that coats the abdominal organs. Regular physical activity trains your body to burn visceral fat more efficiently. When you work out, your body produces more mitochondria, where the aerobic metabolism happens. It makes more proteins to boost the transportation of fatty acids into cells that can be converted into energy. This process creates more enzymes that destroy fat. The more enzymes you have, the faster the visceral fat can be broken down and the better you'll look. Number 1. Hormones. Never underestimate the power of a good sweat. Regular physical exercise can help improve your weight and boost hormone levels. For men, testosterone, which is the hormone that builds bone and muscle growth and increases sex drive, rises for 15 minutes to an hour after exercising. But this varies on your fitness level, age, and how intensely you worked out. Testosterone circulates in the body to create muscle mass. For women, working out can have an impact on estrogen production. Exercising, even in small amounts, can regulate body fat for healthy levels of fertility. It can even help women to sleep better and reduce hot flashes in postmenopausal women. The exercise hormone called orexin also breaks off and circulates throughout your entire body. A UK investigation found that people with more higher levels of orexin in their bodies were more likely to have longer caps at the end of chromosomes that shorten as you get older. This can decrease the risk of Alzheimer's, cancer, and heart disease.
If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.